a scholar has explained this in a very beautiful way. He says, look, the Prophet of Islam said that a son is a blessing, is a ni'mah, but a daughter is a mercy, is a rahmah. And on the day of judgment, Allah will question you about his blessings, but not about his mercy. In other words, the Prophet was describing how a daughter is a rahmah. Okay? So this is one hadith. The other hadith of the Prophet is that in the battle of Khandaq, when Imam Ali alayhi salam was going to fight against Amr bin Abd al-Wad, and there was no one else to fight him, and everything depended on that battle of Imam Ali alayhi salam, the Prophet said, "Baraz al-Imanu kullu ala al-kufri kulli." Complete Iman has now gone forward to fight against complete kufr. So that's another hadith. The other hadith of the Prophet is that a man's Iman is incomplete until he gets married. When he gets married, then his faith is complete. The other hadith of the Prophet ﷺ is that the feet of a mother are jannat for her children. The other hadith of the Prophet ﷺ is Al-Hasan wal-Husayn Sayyidi Shababi Ahlil Jannah. The ayat of Quran is that, O Rasul, we have sent you وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have sent you as a mercy for alameen. Now bring all this together and see Fatima in this light. A daughter is rahmah for the father. The Prophet is rahmatun lil'alameen. Fatima is rahmah for rahmatun lil'alameen. Ali is complete iman. But a man's iman is completed when he gets married. Fatima completes the iman of kul iman. And Hassan and Hussein are Sayyidi Shababi Ahlil Jannah. But Fatima's feet are Jannah for Hassan and Hussein. How then do you describe a lady who is Rahmah for Rahmatul Lil Alameen, who completes the iman of kul iman, whose feet is Jannah for Sayyidi Shababi Ahlil Jannah?